All right, so here's another tutorial using the lovely Entwine Couture. I'm going to be using all of their products. I have already applied all three of the products to my hair. Sectioning in 5 sections. And you can see each section now, it already has a product and it is ready for parting and twisting. Now I want sort of medium to small size flat twists, so I'll part accordingly. And I'll start off by dividing the hair into two and slowly working my way down, bringing each of those pieces across each other in two, kind of like twisting down. Instead of three pieces, you only have two. I'm grabbing a little bit of hair each time, and I will twist the ends up. Let's see how it goes again. I'll divide my first two beginning pieces, right and left piece, and then cross them over. And each time I cross over and twist down, I grab more hair. Almost finished, and I'll show you one last time how I do the top. Divide the first two and twist down, grab hair as you go down. Now I do these twists going towards my face because that's the way I want them to fall. And you'll see once I finish the method to my madness. I'm going to roll my ends up using some of the Creme de la Mold by Entwine. It's a product that has good hold, but it's not crunchy at all, and it's going to be great for my ends. I'm going to roll those up because they are clearly too long and I want to be able to see through my hair. So I roll them up on a roller that does not have the sponge on it. I just use a plastic part so it doesn't snag any of my hair. And just roll it up like a candy curl, and check the length at which it's going to fall periodically, just to make sure I got it right where I want it. Once I finish rolling these up, I'll twist the remainder of my hair down in the back and come back on with it dry. So now the time elapsed has been about 7 hours and it's now nighttime, so I turn the light on so you guys can see me. And I'm just taking it loose. The best thing I like about flat twists is that I do not have to do much separation. Because of the way that they were put in. So I just gently take them down and it's already separated. There will be no more separating after you take them down. So here my whole head's out and it's all defined and separated at the same time. But let's pin those back and do some makeup. I'll do a really quick eye, smoky eye. First, I need to prime my face with MAC's Face Illuminator and Recharge. I've already done my brows, so we'll move on to the eyeshadow. I'm using MAC's Wave Line Fluid Line as a base. It's like a dark purple navy with a little bit of sparkles. My camera really isn't reading it right now. Now for my eyeshadow color, I'm using Frost at Midnight eyeshadow. I use it wet and then I'll take my 217 and blend out my crease with Makeup Forever's number 92, which is a purple color. And I put some engraved in my waterline at the bottom just to define a little bit. And then add some mascara. Add a little blush. This is MAC Raisin and MAC Format. And my lips are going to be Cyber by MAC. And I will line them with MAC Velvetella, which is a really dark purple liner, just to kind of seal in that really vampy purple color. Okay, so makeup is almost done. Just add a little bit of tear duct highlight there. Add a little bit of that number 92 Makeup Forever shadow at the bottom, and we're done. Use my lovely blow dryer to stretch my roots only. I'm just putting a blast of that heat through there just to kind of stretch it and make it fill in those parts a little bit, and I would forget one. You hate it when you forget one. So I just take it and stretch it a little bit. And this is helping me also to mold it over to one side and keep that part that I have there. I have some super duper soft, full curls. Same ones I always get with the Entwine products. Loving it. So you get to see my faces, and then you're gonna see my honey boo boo, my honey boo boo walk right there. And the back is still defined. It's even more defined than my twist out.